photograph. Great. Power up, align the JDACs, and bring up the GPU. First step is to set the electronic fuse for the GPU and then PB3 to begin programming the details of each target. This screen is the GPS weapon display containing essential JDAM information. Starting with the GPU-38 on the station, you now see all the details. Program station 8 with the following data. That narrative. When you finish, press the spacebar. UFC off, but the next step is to program station 2. Press PB13. In the upper left corner, you should see station 2. Program station 2 with the following data. When finished, press the space button. At this point, it is good practice to check the inner data one last time. Using step, shift back and forth between station 2 and station 8. Important, when you are done, since the first two targets are close to each other, you are going to release a single salvo of two JDAM, one from station 8 and one from station 2. Press PB11 and PB14. To select station 2, you are ready to begin the first attack run. On the HSI, set the heading bug to 040. Set autopilot couple be off. When ready to fly, press the spacebar. Observe the HSI and HUD. The time to max range countdown should begin. You will also see the in-range circles on the HSI. On the HSI, when you enter the outer LAR circle, it will change to a pie shape. On the HUD, in zone will appear. Press and hold the weapons release button. take them away. At this point, bring up the target area on the AntFlare by setting autopilot, heading select, be all, then designate waypoint 1 as the target. Maneuver to keep the target area in sight of the AntFlare pod. You are in active pause to observe the JDAM impacts. When ready to continue, press the space bar. Your next target is a bunker. A hard target requiring penetrator weapons. On the left DDI, press PB7J109 as you did with the GPU-38. The JDAM must get next, press PB. This target requires two GPU-30, press PB12 and PB13 to select state in the upper left corner, note toggle to TOO. Next, bring up the target of opportunity. You will notice that in target of opportunity mode, choices are limited to the terminal parameters, heading, angle, and velocity. The JDAMs will require a high angle of impact and a high velocity at impact to aid in target penetration. Enter the below settings, then press the spacebar to continue. Step and repeat the process with the same parameters shown. When finished, press the spacebar to continue. Press push button 13 to set the TOO target coordinates on the HSI. Press push button 12 to step to waypoint 2. On the JDAM display, check to see RP coordinates are returned to the JDAM display page by pressing push button 19. Return to begin the attack run, you will aggressively turn towards the target, set throttle to afterburner, and pitch up to 20 to 25 degrees nose up to begin a climb to 20,000 feet MSL. On the HSI, set the heading bug to the target heading. Turn off autopilot, heading select, and be off. When ready to fly and execute these maneuvers, press the space bar. Climb to 20,000 feet, turn towards the target. On the HUD heading tape, target heading is marked with a small diamond. Steady on a heading to the target. Adjust the heading bug to match the heading to target. Set autopilot, heading select, be all. Accelerate to above 400 knots indicated. When in zone, make sure it rings level, press and hold weapons release until both JDAMs are away. JDAM away. JDAM moved to the target area of the Aftlier and maneuvered to keep the target area in sight of the Aftlier 5. Scud launchers that have been recently delivered by a neutral country IL-76 cargo aircraft. The Scud TELs are the targets. A cargo aircraft is not a target. HSI. Step to waypoint 3. Designate the waypoint as target. Waypoint designated. Set heading bug to target heading. Press the spacebar when complete. Next, make the GBU-38's active again by pressing in order, push button, and press push button 11. Again, we will be dropping both JDAMs in salvage. Press push button 15, 1, followed by push button 11, station 2, and press the mission pay. Toggle the station 8 JDAM to TOO, step 2, station 2, with push button 13, step. Toggle the station 2 JDAM to TOO by pressing push button 5. Press step to return to station 8. This attack will require two sensor to JDAM handoffs. To prepare, complete the following. Right side panel, LTD R to R. Aftlier. Set LTD R to activate on a short trigger pull by selecting trig, push button 11. Make Aftlier soy by pressing OTAS SCS right short. Set Aftlier to scene by pressing OTAS SCS right short again. Upfront controls. Ensure autopilot, heading select, be all is engaged. When ready to fly, press the space bar to continue. Turn towards the target using the aft wing. PDC the aiming point over one of the Scud TELs. Short pull the trigger to get laser range. And press TDC to designate. Press the space bar when you're complete. last step to activate Station 2, TOO, and repeat the targeting steps. TDC the aiming dot over the second tell. Short pull the trigger. Depress TDC. On JDM display, check OPR data. When finished, press the spacebar. Both JDAMs are now targeted. When in zone, press weapons release to drop the JDAM away. Winchester, JDAM. Both JDAMs have detonated. Then press the spacebar. Success. All three targets were successfully attacked. You learned how to employ the JDAM. You may end the lesson now by pressing escape or continue flying by pressing